see you, man. Happy for you. Looking good on the show, right? Hey, there he is. Giving you a shout out right there.
So wait a minute. Live. Do you guys know each other? Hearts are breaking wide open right now just seeing you.
Well, I'm a lot older than Wilmer, but when he came out here, you know, because on the 70s show, I'm always very supportive when I see another Latino out there. Yeah. And he had a heck of a run there, and he's been keeping busy ever since.
No, Mario's always been one of those, you know, a few individuals that's been around not only for so long, but also has been supporting, you know, all the young up-and-coming guys. And you know, when I first came into the game, I was super excited to meet him. First of all, he's still a child. But at the very least, you know, to have people that look like you and sound like you, I make you feel like you can also do it, which was what this guy did. So for so many young
Latinos. That's so cool.
Well, thank you.
That's
thank
awesome.
You, man. That's
no,
great.
No, keeping it super real because we're in our industry. You know, we don't have, you know, we didn't have, when we were growing up, we didn't have a lot of people that we went like, oh, I want to be like this person.
No,
maybe
right,
Desi Arnaz, maybe
Eastside.
And
you're going
maybe,
back to the 50s.
Yeah. Exactly.
That's
Meyer.
Exactly.
No,
exactly.
Yeah, but yeah.
No, but it is great, man. So obviously a successful run on that 70s show. And like I said, he stayed really busy. And now working with Mark Harmon.
Oh, yeah.
Being a special agent. Number one show on TV.
Yeah. Huge.
That's a heck of a run right there.
It's great. I mean, it's been great. I love the cast. I love the crew. You know, I get along with them so great. And Mark Harmon and I are straight up besties, man. We're having
really?
Quite a bromance. Yeah, the guy and I love each other so much, and you know, that's another guy who's done it for so long and still loves coming to work, and I love that. I can relate to that so much.
Is there going to be a little romance with your co-agent? The rumors are circulating. You can see the heat on screen. What are we going to get?
You know, the fans want it, but we don't know what's going to happen. You know, I think ultimately for my character specifically, I know what's happening. In the beginning, when I first joined the show, he was more like a lone wolf. You know, he didn't know how to play well with others. You know, and then he understood the value of being part of a family, being part of this team. And then he lost a couple of team members in the last year or so, and I think that's making him question: does he still want to do this? That's a reason why he worked alone. He didn't develop feelings for anyone. So, is he going to go backwards? He may be going into a dark place this season for sure.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Oh. Another little later.
Wait, he said dark.
Right
I wanted more light and romance.
Yeah, it took a turn.
Took a turn there, Mario.
It's a torture soul.
right.
Exactly.
Still solving crimes though. This is a fun fact because I love. Hearing about it or talking about it. I don't think we ever actually had the conversation, but you actually bought Chuck Norris's house.
Right. Wait, what?
Did you know it was Chuck Norris's house? Or when you got the house, they just told, oh, so you knew it was Chuck Norris's house.
I did. So I lived a mile away from him, and my friend was a realtor there. And he goes, dude, you won't believe whose house I'm
Chuck
selling.
Norris's house is for sale.
And this is during, like, the Chuck Norris jokes, like the jokes that were Chuck Norris can lead a horse to water and make him.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, I was like, oh, I got to see how this
guy
is.
He was kind of like the most interesting man in the world
that. He is.
Yeah.
So, long story short, I was like, dude, I gotta see how this guy lives. So I went in there as a joke, just like being like, oh, this house is funny. Yeah. And then he had a couple of acres in Tarzana. So I was like, I lowballed him. He said yes. He had a big gym.
He left a
total gym.
Oh, really?
You know,
the total gym. Right. The one in the infomercial one. Right.
But here's what's really crazy. It's like he had this big gym, and it's covered in mirrors,
funny.
And he had salmon carpets. And then he had, in the center of it, was a total gym. No joke. Like,
that's
I really
hilarious.
Stood by his product.
This is unbelievable.
Right. Did you get to meet him at all?
I didn't meet
him.
The closest I got to meeting him was signing the contract, and him, his name here, my name
that
here.
That was it.
Like, kiss his face.
Right. I would have bought it sight unseen.
Right? That's so Hollywood. Talk about the Hollywood dream.
That's hilarious.
That's cool.
Man.
Also, how bizarre, like, Fez buys Chuck Norris.
Yeah, that's a great story.
It's super weird.
Speaking of Fez, keep up with all the 70s show, all your castmates. I know you and Ashton stay close. You went on the show and all
oh,
that.
Oh, yeah. We're all best friends. We have a really great time. And, you know, I think, you know, you don't spend 200 episodes in 8 years with people. I mean, you know how it is. Mm-hmm. It's tough. It's tough to move on from those friendships. You spend more time with those people that you spend with anyone in your family. Mm-hmm.
But Mario's EP in the reboot of Saved by the Bell, maybe you do a little EP.
Oh, by the way, my nephew, this is such a weird Hollywood talk, but my nephew is up for the show.
Oh,
is he really?
Why don't you do a little pitch?
I'm just saying, if he doesn't see it, about the Rama on the show, he didn't get the part.
No, let me know. That's good. That's good to know. Yeah, fun fact.
But that's
right
cool.
There.
Are you excited for that?
Yeah, no, I'm excited. We're sort of developing it and stuff. It's really going to be more about these kids, right? And we'll just kind of come pop in and stuff. But I'm sure you get asked all the time about certain reboots, but you're busy, and pretty much most of the cast has stayed very busy. So
yeah, I know we've been very fortunate. I think that when I took that long break from TV, you know, and you know, when you do long running stuff, you eventually at some point you need to take some time to remind yourself of who you are. You know, you got to reboot, you got to evolve as a person. And I certainly did a lot growing up, you know, in those years that I was away from television. A lot of stuff was consuming, you know, but I feel like you find other passions, like producing, and then you still stay creative and stay developing. And I think directing is something I love doing as well. So that kept me really inspired. And then eventually you get the bug and you got to perform again, right? But that's kind of how it all works. But I think we're very fortunate. I believe that everybody woke up every morning, swang as hard as possible, and now they're still working.
Yeah, we love watching you.
Yeah. Right on, man.
Good to see you. Have fun in New York.
Be sure to check out Wilmer. NCIS airs Tuesday nights on CBS.